you predict that Apple will benefit from its announcement on Monday about its new streaming service. But it really seems like there are a couple different pieces here that you think will reduce Apple's churn. What's your case for this significant upside?
Right. So the basis of it is we did a survey, and users of Apple products think they're buying into an ecosystem. And if Apple was valued like an ecosystem company, the share price would rise to about $265 a share, up 40%. Secondly, the most important aspect of an ecosystem's valuation is churn, because the lower the churn, the higher the lifetime value per user. And on Monday, we think they're going to announce two services that will lower churn, and that will add to the value overall of the ecosystem at Apple.
Now, Laura, the two services you're talking about are a streaming video service, which is, from what I understand, going to compete sort of with an HBO, and then also a news service. Do you think that these services are going to actually add incremental revenue, or do you think they're just going to be about keeping people in that Apple family?
Right. So you want to lower churn. So they have 900 million users today. If 10% of those, so 90 million, pay $100 a year, that's $9 billion of extra revenue, which we'll put a multiple on. Call it $30 or $40 billion of value creation if they create services that get adopted by unique users they have and or attracts new users to the ecosystem.
Laura, my concern would be Apple's still an iPhone company, by and large, when it comes to revenue and especially profit, and they haven't really proven their chops in services. Yes, in app stores, retail, digital transactions. Yes, in software, certainly in design and hardware. But is it safe to value them in that way, considering that the iPhone and its sales cycle are still somewhat in question?
Right. So, I mean, I do think you're espousing the consensus view that Apple is a device company, but I would really point to the social pressure of turning off your iPhone, because there's a lot of services that only are in existence between iPhone owners, and there's a lot of social pressure not to leave that ecosystem when you try to go to an Android. And that really creates stickiness in addition to whatever services you lose that are unique to iPhone. So I, again, back to this ecosystem idea, I don't think it's the specific iPhone device that's at play here. It's the add-on devices, the add-on features like sharing across photos and new services like Monday's announcement in addition to Apple Music.
Hey, Laura, your sell-side colleagues have been busy today as well. I wanted to throw some numbers at you, see if you agree. One is 100 million subs for Apple, realistic over the medium term, yes or no?
100 million subs for the new services they're going to announce on Monday, you think?
Yep.
Yep, I think totally reasonable. That's 10% of their total base, yep.
How about a $100 billion buyback?
Yep. No problem. They have said they've stated they want to get to net cash zero on the balance sheet. And today their net cash position is $130 billion of net cash. So assuming they're going to keep them their word, the problem is this company generates $60 billion a year of free cash flow. So it's hard for them to keep up with all the cash flow if they want to get to net cash zero on the balance sheet.